ancestral Mary Molly gossip.
To sign a ball, saying that
God
she's not
bless sick. You, my child.
I'm sure for us
we
all.
Love he you, my little lie. Match girl princess, and you are my match girl princess. Oh, how am I doing?
Maisie, sweetheart, you're bloody marvellous. For a woman of 104, you're quite breathtaking. Family, Maisie, they've been on at me.
Oh, no, not again! But I wrote to the interfering old sods, Chris!
Dear Arnie and Urs, Miss Tate, who thinks she has the right to poke her nose into my business, has been telling me that you're both very worried about my future. Well, can I just state, here and now, and once and for all, that if you don't like it, you can frigging well lump it. So there. Yours as ever, your loving mother. P.S. I think I'm pregnant again.
They depress me, Maisie.
I told you, ignore them. I do. What did they say?
Who?
Oh, Arnold the impotent and her frosty flow.
Aye, the usual. At first I took no notice, but now they're beginning to get to me. They're under the impression that you're giving me money, sponsoring the show.
That can be Miss Tate.
I'm afraid so. They've even got a doctor's report to say that, well, you're incapable. And Ursula rang me in the middle of the night.
Do you realise what you're doing? My mother-in-law was perfectly happy and content till you came along. Happy to end her days in Mwldan. She's not a well woman, Mr. Tavistock's wife. She has dizzy spells. You put her at the top of a staircase like that, and I shudder to think what might occur. Supposing she fell, what then? You'd have that on your conscience. Now, really, is it worth it?
What's worse, Maisie, I'm beginning to believe it. Look, how can I do you any harm? What if something were to happen? What then? Look, sweetheart, we start rehearsals proper on Monday. It will mean 4 weeks' hard work, long hours. Are you up for it?
Oh, no, you're talking to me as if I'm... God, I'm furious. I'm flaming furious. What should happen, for God's sake? Oh, just look at me. I haven't been this happy since Bunty St. James fell down her own stairs at Attercliffe Palace.
That's not funny, Maisie.
No, that's the trouble, isn't it? That... is the trouble. Nothing's funny anymore. Look, love, the only way I've got through my life is through laughing. I got pregnant to a second-rate trumpet player who would have preferred to have slept with a bloke on the drums. And I chose to keep the baby, even though my dad wanted me to get rid of it. Oh, and the shame of it. It wasn't easy in them days, you know. Now nobody cares what you do. Oh, wanting to be in the theatre, my God! You were the lowest of the low. Cocking your legs up for half a crown and tatting around the country with a suitcase in one hand and a cross-eyed kid in the other. You had to laugh. And look at the child. In the name of heaven, look at the child. Oh, bless him. I know it's not his fault. But it's not just in later life he's got like that, you know. He's been like that since day one. And now, after 10 years in a converted cowshed in Wimbledon, I end up here. Long autumn. And I thought, well, at least here I'll get a laugh. And what happened? Nothing. The autumn is too blooming long. Aimless, cheerless. Look, love, you've come along and have given me a second chance, a last chance. Who knows, I might get to be 104.
I'm sorry, Maisie.
Giving you money indeed. Didn't you tell them you were a millionaire?
Well, I said I was nearly a millionaire.
Oh, God, well, that was fatal. And Arnold will have pounced on the word nearly.
Yeah, well, he said he'd be looking into
it. You'll be having you scrutinised.
Well, that's what I'm afraid of.
Look here, Mr. Whatever your name is. We can't let them stop us.
No?
No, just because I'm 104 doesn't mean I've got one foot in the grave.
No. No. Actually, she's got 2 feet in the grave. Look, we could bill you as the oldest woman ever to set foot on a stage. Now that will pack them in.
Yeah, do you mind? I'm not that bloody old.
How old?
Well, I'm... Oi, watch it. I think I'm nearly 70. Now look here. Do you want me to take this part in your play or not?
I do.
And you want me to be in your show?
Well, yes.
Right then. Maisie May is on her way. Oxford. Here we come!
Maestro.
Music.
Please.
Please. There's no business like show business. There's no business I know. Everything about it is appealing. Everything the traffic will allow.
There's no people like show people, they smile.